Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, first we are going to discuss infinite limit of a function. Let f of x be a function of x if the value of x can be made greater than any pre-assigned number by taking x close to a then the function f of x becomes positively infinite as x approaches to a that is limit f of x as x tends to a is equal to plus infinity. Similarly, if the value of f of x can be made less than any pre-assigned number by taking x close to a, then the function f of x becomes negatively infinite as x approaches to a that is limit of f of x as x tends to a is equal to minus of infinity. Now we are going to discuss about trigonometric limits. And first we have limit sine of alpha as alpha tends to 0 is equal to 0 and limit cos of alpha as alpha tends to 0 is equal to 1. Let alpha be an angle in the standard position and it is measured in radians here. Alpha is the angle between the lines OQ and OP. From the point P, draw PQ perpendicular to the x-axis. Then we have sine of angle alpha, which is given by perpendicular upon hypotenuse is equal to PQ upon OP. That is, sine of alpha is equal to perpendicular PQ upon hypotenuse OP. When alpha is getting smaller and smaller, then P will get closer and closer to Q, which implies that as alpha tends to 0, PQ will tend to 0. That is, PQ by OP will tend to 0. Therefore, as alpha tends to 0, sine of alpha will also tend to 0. Now, cos of alpha given by base upon hypotenuse, that is OQ upon OP. Here we have cos alpha is equal to base OQ upon hypotenuse OP. As alpha is getting smaller and smaller, then P will get closer and closer to Q, which implies that as alpha tends to 0, OP will tend to OQ. Therefore, OQ upon OP will tend to 1. Therefore, as alpha tends to 0, cos of alpha will tend to 1. As OQ upon OP will tend to 1 and is equal to cos of alpha, hence, limit sin of alpha as alpha tends to 0 is equal to 0 and limit cos of alpha as alpha tends to 0 is equal to 1. Next we have limit sin of x by x as x tends to 0 is equal to 1. Let there be a unit circle with center O. This is the unit circle with center O. Let angle AOB is equal to x radians. Angle AOB is equal to x radians. Now we join AB and draw AC perpendicular to OA at A. Produce OB to meet AC at C. Now from this figure, it is clear that area of triangle OAB is less than area of sector OAB and is less than area of triangle OAC. So we have area of triangle OAB is less than area of sector OAB. Is less than area of triangle OAC, which implies that area of triangle OAB is equal to 1 by 2 into OA into OB into sin of x is less than area of sector OAB, which is equal to 1 by 2 into OA square into x is less than area of triangle OAC, which is given by 1 by 2 into OA into AC. Since we have taken a unit circle, therefore the length of the radius OA is equal to 1 unit and the length of the radius OB is also equal to 1 unit. Therefore we have 1 by 2 into OA, that is 1, into OB, that is 1, into sin of x is less than 1 by 2 into OA square, that is 1 square, into x is less than 1 by 2 into OA, that is 1, into AC, which is equal to tan of x. Since OAC is a right angle triangle, therefore tan of x is given by perpendicular AC by base OA. So we have AC is equal to OA into tan of x and we know that OA is equal to 1. So we have 1 into tan of x, which is equal to tan of x. So AC is equal to tan of x. Therefore we have 1 by 2 into sin of x is less than 1 by 2 into x is less than 1 by 2 into tan of x, which can be written as sin of x is less than tan of x, which implies that 1 is less than x by sin of x is less than 1 by cos of x. And we have 1 is greater than sin of x by x is greater than cos of x. Therefore, the value of sin of x by x lies in between 1 and cos of x. From our previous result, we know that limit cos of x as x tends to 0 is equal to 1. Therefore, when x tends to 0, the value of sin of x by x lies in between 1 and 1, that is, limit sin of x by x as x tends to 0 is equal to 1, or we can also write it as limit x by sin of x as x tends to 0 is equal to 1. Here, x is expressed in radians, and we should note that if x is given in degrees, that is x degrees, then it should be converted into radians by using the formula x degrees is equal to pi into x upon 180 radians, and then we have limit tan of x by x as x tends to 0 is equal to 1. We have limit tan of x by x as x tends to 0, which can be written as limit tan of x is equal to sin of x by cos of x whole upon x as x tends to 0, which can also be written as limit sin of x by x into 1 upon cos of x as x tends to 0, that is limit sin of x by x as x tends to 0 into limit 1 upon cos of x as x tends to 0. From our previous result, we know that limit sin of x by x as x tends to 0 is equal to 1 into limit 1 upon cos of x as x tends to 0. So we have 1 into, now putting the value of x as 0 in this expression, we get 1 upon cos of 0, which is equal to 1 into 1 upon cos of 0, that is 1 upon 1, as cos of 0 is equal to 1. So we have 1 into 1, that is 1. Hence, limit tan of x by x as x tends to 0 is equal to 1. Now we shall discuss some special limits. First we have limit e raised to power x minus 1 whole upon x as x tends to 0 is equal to 1. Next we have limit log of 1 plus x by x as x tends to 0 is equal to 1. Then we have limit a raised to power x minus 1 upon x as x tends to 0 is equal to log of a to the base e. Next is limit 1 plus 1 upon x whole raised to power x as x tends to infinity is equal to e. Then we have limit 1 plus x whole raised to power 1 upon x as x tends to 0 is equal to e. Next is limit 1 plus a upon x whole raised to power x as x tends to infinity is equal to e raised to power a. Now we shall discuss indeterminate limits. If f of x takes any of the form
that is 0 by 0, infinity by infinity, infinity minus infinity, 0 into infinity, 0 raised to power 0, 1 raised to power infinity, and infinity raised to power 0 at x is equal to a, then f of x is indeterminate at x is equal to a. Now we are going to discuss L'Hopital's rule. L'Hopital's rule states that if f of a by g of a is of the form zero by zero or infinity by infinity, then limit f of x by g of x as x tends to a is equal to limit f dash of x by g dash of x as x tends to a, that is differentiating numerator and denominator separately. Now we shall learn about geometrical interpretation of dy by dx. Let us consider the curve y is equal to f of x. Let f of x be a differentiable function. Let P with the coordinates x, f of x, and Q with the coordinates x plus delta x, f of x plus delta x be two points on the curve. From the points P and Q, draw PL and QM perpendicular to the x-axis. Let PN be perpendicular to NQ. Then slope of the chord PQ is given by tan of the angle QPN. Since we know that QPN is a right angle triangle, therefore tan of angle QPN is given by perpendicular upon base, that is QN upon PN. Therefore we can write tan of angle QPN is equal to QN upon PN, and QN is given by f of x plus delta x minus f of x, and PN is equal to delta x. Therefore we have QN, that is f of x plus delta x minus f of x upon PN, which is given by delta x. Let Q tends to P, that is we have delta x tends to 0. So we have limit slope of chord PQ as Q tends to P is equal to limit f of x plus delta x minus f of x whole upon delta x as delta x tends to 0. As Q tends to P, chord PQ tends to the tangent to y is equal to f of x at P. Therefore, slope of the tangent at P is equal to limit f of x plus delta x minus f of x by delta x as delta x tends to 0, which implies that slope of the tangent at P is equal to limit f of x plus delta x minus f of x upon delta x as delta x tends to 0, which can be written as f dash of x. That is, we have tan of phi is equal to f dash of x, where psi is the inclination of the tangent to the curve y is equal to f of x at the point P with coordinates x, f of x with the axis. Therefore, we have dy by dx is equal to tan of psi. Hence, the derivative at any point P is the tangent of the angle that the tangent to the curve at P makes with the positive direction of x-axis. And thus follows the two results. First is, if the tangent is parallel to the x-axis, then psi is equal to 0. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to tan of psi, which is equal to tan of 0, that is 0. And if the tangent is perpendicular to the x-axis, then psi is equal to 90 degrees and cot of psi, that is cot of 90 degrees, is equal to 0. Therefore, we have dx by dy is equal to 0, or we can also write it as dy by dx is equal to infinity. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.